Alright guys, it is really nice to see that most smartphone users and Android users in particular are paying attention towards open source community. I think it is important to understand that privacy is one of the most crucial things in this world of technology. Your data should remain safe and you should have a complete control on how your data is getting processed. And that's one of the most important benefits of using open source applications. The code is publicly available and these applications, they generally collect less or no data and have minimal permissions. And that's why I have selected 5 unique open source applications for today's video. Remember, less permissions, less data collection, and great features. Let's get started. At present, there are tons of online options available to listen to any kind of audio because there are so many online audio players available right now. But if you prefer downloading the audio first and then listening to it on your phone, like that old school type, there's one excellent open source application called the Phoenix Project. It is an offline music player and is completely free of cost. It offers some really good features like the support for lyrics or the dynamic background. This player also gives you an option of setting a ringtone where you can change the range you want to use and you can also fade the music. You can also exclude the music that is below 30 seconds, choose the custom scan option and set the artwork as a lock screen wallpaper. One of the most unique features about this music player is the flashlight visualizer that will run while playing music and you can also change the strength. It is a cool feature but might be heavy on the device battery. Apart from all these awesome features, there are no advertisements and no trackers, so it is definitely worth trying. And this application is available on Google Play Store, so please check the download link in the video description. You know that having an Android phone is all about customization and wallpapers play an important role in that. And if you get all the wallpapers for free, then it is like an icing on the cake. Now, there are only a few open source wallpaper applications available out there and WallU is among one of them. This application is slowly starting to become one of my favorite wallpaper applications and there's a reason for that. It includes 4 amazing wallpaper sources like Wallhaven, Unsplash, Owalls and Pixum, and it does not compromise on the wallpaper quality. It also includes wallpaper changer from all these 4 sources with intervals ranging from 15 minutes to 1 day. You can filter out wallpapers depending on what you want to look at. Let's say you want some abstract wallpapers. Well, you simply enter abstract in this filter category and tap on the order you want these wallpapers to appear. And there you have amazing abstract wallpapers. You can add wallpapers to your favorite category or even save the wallpapers to your phone. There's also an option to change the wallpaper blur or even grayscale the wallpapers and that's pretty amazing. So if you are looking for a wallpaper application for your phone without spending any money, WallU is definitely a great choice. I recently posted a video about open source applications where I covered one application called Photon, which is a cross-platform application to share files between different devices. Well, at number 3 we have an application similar to Photon called as LocalSend that can help you share files or messages between nearby devices using local Wi-Fi network. Apart from being a free application, it does not require any internet and there are no advertisements and no unnecessary tracking. I really like the interface of this application, it is very neat. LocalSend gives you an option of quick save where file request is automatically accepted and you can also choose between single and multiple recipients depending on the number of devices you are using. As far as the availability goes, you can download this application on Android, iOS, macOS, Windows and Linux. So yeah, there's a great coverage already. This application is definitely better than those file sharing applications you find on Google Play Store that have like so many privacy issues. So this one is definitely recommended. Now back to Android customization. Minimal Android launchers are getting really popular nowadays as most of us want to be more productive. I know there are different options available out there, but if you are looking for an open source alternative, Focus Launcher is going to be a great choice. It is simple, effective and offers some really nice features like icon pack support, adding applications to your favorite section or even hiding applications. If you take a look at this main homepage, you will find the favorite applications arranged in these boxes and it looks really good. You also get this fancy animated clock along with lunar phase information. If you want to delete or reorder these applications, you can simply long press and tap on the application you want to reorder and place it anywhere you want. It is really smooth and easy. And yes, there are no advertisements and no hidden cost, so make sure to check this one out. Now, I was really confused about selecting the last application for today's video and I finally went with Image Resizer. If you want to make any kind of modifications to your photos like cropping, resizing or changing the image format, Image Resizer is going to be really helpful. This small application is capable of doing more than what you would expect. And on top of that, it comes with Material View design, so it has a very attractive interface. Taking a deep dive into advanced features, you can edit the exif data or choose from the already provided presets to help you quickly resize the image. You can also choose the extension for the output image and that's going to help you change any image from one format to another. You also get an undo button at the bottom to help you quickly go back to the original image. I won't be going into detail about each and every feature, but I just wanted to show you one last feature, and that's the Telegram sticker pattern, where you can quickly change the image size to match the Telegram sticker size by simply tapping this Telegram icon at the bottom left. After saving the file, you can then simply go to Telegram and add the sticker to your collection. These are just some of the main features of this application, but if you want to explore it more, I will leave a link in the video description, so make sure to check it out. Okay, so this was not planned and I'm recording this part a bit later, but I thought to include one bonus application for today's video, and it is an excellent music player known as Harmonoid. As far as the availability goes, you can download it for Android obviously, but it is available for Linux and Windows as well. Talking about features, well, there are a lot actually, but let's take a look at some of the best ones. Starting with the design, well, it is a material-based music player with great UI and animations. It also supports lyrics, and the most interesting part is that there is an option of notification lyrics, and it works flawlessly. You can also adjust the speed or pitch of anything you are listening to, and there is also an option of volume boost. You can also play online URLs, but I don't know, I wasn't able to play anything. If you are testing it, let me know if it is working fine for you. I also did a quick test on my laptop and it was working fine. I will leave the official download link in the video description, so make sure to check it out because it is an excellent audio management application. And I guess that was pretty much everything about today's video. Let me know in the comments about your favorite application from today's video. And if you are new to my channel, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel as well. That would be really great. And if you are interested in trying some other open source applications in your phone, I have already made a couple of other videos on this topic and you should be able to see them on your screen right now. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.